Hello everyone, Ian Foxley here. Welcome to another video. Today I'm going to focus on Genesis Mining, and this video is going to be about the fact that they've just added credit card option now to their interface. So now you can order a credit card. So there are some limitations. I'll just go through some of them. First of all, how you can order a credit card is you just click on US dollar option before, you know, to get the screen of all the different options, and credit card is at the top. You then choose how much you want to purchase. Now, with credit card, you can only order over $50 and under $500. There is a $500 limit, and there is also a $50 limit. So if you want to order, for example, 20 gigahash, then this is not going to work for you. If you do try, then you will get this message once you've done this. For credit card payment, minimum amount for order is $50. And you will get the same kind of a message when you order anything over $500, for example. So this is 533. There you go. Daily limit of 500 is reached. So there you go. So basically at the moment it's between $50 and $500. I'm not sure basically if you are a very good customer whether they give you a higher limit. Maybe they raise your limit depending on how often that you use a credit card and how often you then might get trusted. I've got no idea. You know, I'm just saying things as I see them. Now, interestingly enough, there are fees using a credit card. For those of you that are used to bank wire transfers, you're probably used to fees anyway, so this might not affect you too much. But for those of you that use credit cards often, you know, for shopping online, you'll probably be a bit surprised about those charges. They've probably used them for security reasons, because obviously as they're dealing with cryptocurrency, and also Genesis Mining is using another company as a credit card processor, and I'll show you a little bit more about the credit card processor in a moment. But I just want to show you, for example, an example of what happens when you do an order. So for example, I've just ordered 0.1 terahash and that costs $71. So I click on continue and I get told that there is a transfer fee of £10. So this is obviously a fee that the credit card processor, not Genesis Mining, have obviously asked for you to pay as a fee for using their processing service, I think. You can use promo codes as always. So if you do enter in my promo code, you will get a 3% discount on top as well. So for example, this will go from $71 down to $68.97, so that's a few dollars saved there. Now, a little bit more about the payment processor. Now, the payment processor is Simplex, so that is who Genesis Mining are using for the Bitcoin credit card payments. They do have an FAQ here as well, so if you click on FAQ on their website, you can find out all about the FAQ if you want some answers to some of your questions. Now, basically, Simplex have some pages here, and it tells you a little bit about who they are, basically, and other stuff like that. So there's terms of use, for example, and they also mention about that. So for example, if you look at the FAQ and you want to talk about the charges, what are the service fees? Service fees are presented clearly on the payment page, and basically, are there any limits? Yes, there are periodical limits. Daily limit is 500 and a monthly limit is 5000, for example. So there you go. So that's basically what Genesis Mining are doing. Some of you might find that useful. Another thing I will show you is this though. I did an order with credit card just now, and basically I will show you what happens after you've ordered with credit card. Right then, so I ordered by credit card, and the first thing I'll see is this box that comes up now, and it says, "Thank you for your order. We wish to point out that your credit card order is still under review, and all your payments for contracts paid with credit card will be held for 30 days. You can still use the mining allocation and allocate your coins and review your payments. After the probation period of 30 days ends, you will receive your payments at once." So basically what it's told me is that the credit card order that I've just done, it's now going to hold all of my coins, all of my payouts for 30 days. I think this is just to protect themselves so that basically nobody can do chargebacks, because in the past people have ordered bitcoins or paid with PayPal and other companies, and then after a few days of getting payouts, or just when they get to that time when they can actually claim their money back, they will get to like the period after they've even got payouts and say, oh, I want a chargeback. And then the credit card company will fund them the money, and then also they will get to keep all the coins. So basically, I think this is Genesis Mining's way of protecting. But it's good for me to do this for you now, so that some of you are aware of what will happen, so that if you do purchase, then you won't be sitting there thinking, oh crap, you know, I can't actually get any of my money now for 30 days. To me, it doesn't bother me that my payouts are frozen or kept for 30 days, because, you know, I tend to just keep my Bitcoin payments anyway. But for some of you who might be doing, for example, mining, and then you'll be getting your daily outgoings and going to an exchange, then maybe credit card option isn't for you. I can understand why Genesis Mining are doing this, though. This is for their own security. And, you know, and obviously they don't want anyone to abuse the system, because obviously if the system gets abused, then credit card will get taken away. And, you know, I think there's a lot of people out there that would like credit cards to remain now and not for it just to vanish again. So that's basically it, really. So I hope you found this little video useful about the paying card. I didn't actually go through the actual credit card payment screen, because obviously there's lots of private information that you have to enter there, and obviously I don't really want to tell everyone all my private information out to the world. But once you do click on continue, there is a screen where you have to enter in your name and address and your credit card number, and then obviously and what kind of card you want to use. But I obviously haven't used that, shown you that screen, obviously for the reasons I've just said. So thank you for watching this video. I hope you found it useful. I'm sure some of you might be looking at this video now and will be put off by paying by credit card, but it's obviously good for you to know the details now. And there will also be some of you now that normally use bank wire transfer who will probably be very happy about the fact that Genesis Mining have got credit card now. So thanks for watching. Come back again for another video soon. Bye for now.